Today we're going to explore the Europa, a beautiful example of European design applied to light aircraft. The Europa family of planes provide fast, efficient, comfortable flying in an all-composite two-seater aircraft designed to operate on the varied runway surfaces of Europe. The initial design was a monowheel. Wait a second, only one main wheel? Is this where the one wheel got its inspiration? How the heck do you land that thing? Well, let's see. Looks to me like you stick it to the ground like you would most tail draggers. There's a lot more to know about this cool airplane family, and I was able to interview three owners at the Columbia, California airport, each with a unique perspective on the Europa family of airplanes. Be sure to stay to the end where I will give you some links to more information about this aircraft platform. We will investigate three planes and learn what it's like to fly one. Here are the three pilots we will hear from in this video. Kim helped bring Europas to the United States, and he is still flying one of the first monowheel Europas he and his dad completed many years ago.
Well, thank you, Chris, for being here and taking the time to introduce everybody to the Europa.
Thorsten also flies a monowheel, but his plane is the newer Europa XS, and it was one of the first Europas fitted with the turbocharged Rotax 914 engine.
Europa actually advertised it's a flying dream, and yes, it is a flying dream because it's super easy on the handles, on the stick. It really flies very nicely.
Dave flies the motor glider version of the Europa, where much longer wings are fitted to the fuselage. In theory, you could have two sets of wing and fly your Europa either as a motor glider or a basic single engine land aircraft.
This right here is a motor glider. It does not require the blessing of the government to fly. It's a 115 horsepower turbocharged airplane with long wings.
The Europa Classic made its way to the United States in the mid-1990s, shortly after its introduction in the UK. The first kits were delivered to US builders around 1995-1996, with increasing adoption among home builders through the late 1990s. Kim was one of the first in the United States to have a completed Europa. Let's hear how he got the Europa started here in the US.
I had a friend in Sweden that thought I would be interested in the Europa. Kind of a blend between maybe a long easy and a J4. Kind of like that, if they had a baby. My dad and I actually went over to England and met Ivan Shaw, who was the designer and developer of the aircraft. And we hit it off as good friends, and I've been a friend with Ivan ever since. Then we bought the first series of the kits. It was always developed to use the Rotax series of engines, the 912 series of engines, which was kind of unusual in the United States. The Rotax was associated essentially with two-stroke engines. So there was kind of an awkward feel to other flyers out there, but I knew the design of the engine was good and everything. So 2 years later, the airplane was complete. Ivan Shaw took an interest in getting this thing to Oshkosh so he could present it. So Ivan and I did fly this out to Oshkosh from Chino.
What year was that when you flew it to Oshkosh?
That was 1996.
Okay.
Based on those experiences and Ivan's confidence in my ability to build the airplane and talk about it, he decided he wanted to have me represent the company in the Western states. This is actually one of the very first ones in the US to fly. But over the years, there were some important iterations and improvements to the aircraft.
And that is a good segue to Thorsten's Europa XS, the more American-sized version of the Europa. Thorsten's plane is also a monowheel version of the Europa, so let's talk about that experience. But you know, before we get to Thorsten, if you enjoy these pilot stories and adventures, please subscribe to this channel, Silva Adventures, to ensure you get alerted as my future stories are published. Now let's get back to hearing more about the Europa monowheel from Thorsten.
I notice you have just one big tire in the center and you've got these little skinny wheels on the wings. Talk a little bit about what is that like and what's the advantage of having it configured like that?
I mean, the whole recipe to make it so efficient is actually the monowheel. That you can actually also retract the monowheel. So during the flights, the monowheel is retracted, the outriggers are retracted, and so it's really slippery in the air. And even if you want to go into land and you just have that one wheel, it's actually nicely damped with a bungee cord. And it's actually meant to land on grass, what we have here. It was designed that way from Ivan Shaw in Britain to do such thing. And so it's actually pretty all-rounder. You can go into rough country fields and you still can go and have a smooth ride in the air. If you have a tri-gear, yes, it's easier to land because the downside on a monowheel is it's pretty squirrely. in crosswinds. So we really have to watch out and make sure you have the tail down at the same time you have actually the main down to keep controls even in the lower speeds and don't get weathercocked into the wind. So that's pretty much a trick on the monowheel.
Now I noticed the elevators on the tail look like they rotate as well. Can you talk a little
Correct.
Bit about
so
that?
Those are stabilators what we have there, okay. And that makes it pretty efficient. It's also pretty pitch sensitive, however, but it gives you a good authority on the pitch, which you especially need for the landing. It actually likes to float. Just coming in here to the grass strip, if you have calm winds, yes, you can land short, but you still it wants to float. It gets in the ground effect because of the low wing setting. So it's actually pretty roomy. The Europa is actually wider than a Cessna 172, and it actually gives you a really nice room on your elbows and if you fly with somebody. And it's actually big enough to put a bicycle in it. So I sometimes take my mountain bike in it, take the wheels out and put the bike in the back and can take it up to go mountain biking.
That's amazing.
So I have a 914 engine in it, which is turbocharged, so it Rotax. Really gets me up to altitude. Also, if I just want to cruise, I currently have just a fixed pitch propeller on it, but even with the fixed pitch propeller, it gives me 135 knots cruise on about 5.5 gallons,
wow.
Which is pretty efficient. If I slim it down just to 120 knots, I'm cruising between 3 and 3.5 gallons an hour. And that makes it really fun. But in general, the payload of that one is actually pretty good. Mine is actually opened to 1,375 pounds in max gross, and the empty weight is at 900 pounds. But since I just have 18 gallons of fuel, so it actually gives me a pretty good payload.
Now let's talk about the glider version. We'll start with Kim talking about his experience on the glider wing versus the standard wing of the Europa.
Have you flown the glider version?
Yes. When I was at Sun and Fun several years ago, the motor glider was being introduced at that time. I don't remember the year. And it was the prototype. So I did have a chance to fly it. I was pretty surprised that it flies very much like the standard Europa.
Wow.
It does take a little more rudder, but the controls feel very familiar.
Huh.
The pitch attitude and all this. It's a great cruising machine. I think Dave can talk about that. And when you put the spoilers out, it does come down pretty quickly as designed.
Yeah.
But it just felt like a bigger version of this
Europa.
Aircraft.
Okay.
Now let's check out Dave's Europa motor glider.
I'm the launch motor glider guy. So
oh,
this
wow.
is the first customer built to fly motor glider. It's the same thing as the other airplane over there, the short wing version, except the wings are long. It doesn't have flaps. It has combination, I don't know what they call them, that trailing edge device that's like spoiler on the top, flap on the bottom, and it affects the stall speed. And that's what you use drag control. It's the mono gear, so it's retractable. The glide ratio is claimed to be 27:1, but I think it's more realistically about 24:1. It's the kind of airplane where if the engine quits, like if you're at cruise altitude and the engine quits, you start wondering why the engine quit, and you don't even really have to think about landing it, like where am I going to land? Because, for example, if you're at, since the turbocharger, if you're at 17,000 feet, it's over the Central Valley of California, you'll have about close to an hour before you're on the ground. That's a long time when you think about it. You can fill out your wheel and everything on the way down. This is maybe the world's only three-axis autopilot equipped motor glider. I had to make it overcomplicated because I wanted to fly a complex aircraft, and this was the way to do it without the blessing of the medical certificate.
You mentioned you were the builder. What's the build experience like?
I bought the quick build kit because I wanted to build it quickly, oddly enough. It came with all the control surfaces pre-built, and the wing is carbon fiber, so the wing is something that you glue together. I know they don't want you to say glue. Use adhesive, aerospace adhesive to bond the wing. But it came that way. But there's an amazing amount of things you gotta do to build one of these airplanes that even goes beyond the kit. The kit will get you, the instructions will get you an airplane that looks like an airplane, but you still have to have an electrical system. You have to have the fuel system. There's a lot of details that they don't really specify exactly how to do. This was a well documented build, I think. The RVs are legendary for being good about that, but this one was good. I mostly fly it like an airplane, like the long wing airplane. And if it's got glider wings, you got to do glider stuff. So the first thing I had to do is get a glider rating. So I went and got that. Not only that, but I also have to do a, even though you have 23,000 hours in powered aircraft, you still have to get an endorsement in your logbook to fly a motor glider. So I got that. I used to fly back and forth to the Bay Area because I flew out of the Bay Area, and I would use the airplane to go back and forth. And when I fly, one time flying back past Placerville, looking at distance to go to Minden, and at 17,500 on oxygen, I'm thinking, I think I can glide there. And if I can't glide there, I can certainly make it to South Lake Tahoe. I had a 10 knot tailwind. So it took me maybe 3 minutes to cool the engine, slow down, shut down, feather, but it works all the way, gliding all the way in and landing. I just did that because. Taking advantage of glider wings though mostly is like flying here. I flew direct from Minden. I went to 14.5 this time. And you've got all your software that gives you your glide ratio and the terrain and everything. And if you look, there's, it's not an ideal alternate, but the Bear Valley Stoll port. And then there's another airport with a 4,000 foot runway out there. And then there's, of course, South Lake Tahoe, and there's Markleyville, or not Markleyville, Alpine County. But you can fly across the Sierras in this thing, and if the engine quits, you will get to an airport. And, you know, if I'm in a Cessna, not that I'm anything against Cessnas, but I really enjoy that. So you think, well, why doesn't he just get the short wings? It'll go 10 knots faster. I don't see a reason.
As these interviews demonstrate, the Europa aircraft is a versatile package that provides an efficient and fun flying experience in a number of different configurations. As I take a short flight with Thorsten around the pattern, I'm reminded why I love general aviation. Of course, seeing the world from the air is pretty special, but general aviation pilots share a unique bond, and overall they are a great community to be a part of. This YouTube video was my excuse to spend a few hours getting to know these pilots better. Not just learning about their planes, but hearing their stories, their journeys, and what drew them to the Europa. Whether it's Kim's role in bringing the Europa to the US, Thorsten's love of efficiency and adventure, or Dave's logical approach to efficient commuting, each of them brings something unique to this aircraft community and to aviation as a whole. At the end of the day, it's not just about the airplanes. It's about the people you meet along the way. So to all the pilots, builders, and dreamers out there, keep flying, keep dreaming, and most of all, keep sharing your passion. If you'd like more information about the Europa, I highly recommend the Europa Club or the Europa Aircraft Owners Facebook group. I'll put the links in the comment section below. This format of sharing demands some level of brevity. If you want to dive deeper on the Europa, I will share a more complete version of Kim's interview in the show notes. You will hear more detail about Kim's experiences and more unique features of the Europa aircraft. Be sure to check it out in the show notes if you're interested. Thanks for coming along on this Silva adventure, and be sure to subscribe so you can see the next one.